Hey guys, so I'm really excited about today's painting. I'm a big fan of MotoGP racing, and if you don't know what that is, MotoGP racing is the highest level of motorcycle racing, and they race around tracks around the world, and it's similar to like what Formula One would be for cars. You can't buy a Formula One car, you know, it's millions of dollars and it's super high tech. Well, you can't buy a MotoGP bike. These are purpose-made track bikes just for these guys that have gotten to the championship level, and now these guys are the top of the line. So these racers race for different manufacturers, Ducati, you know, Suzuki, KTM and Honda and Yamaha. So like, these guys are the absolute very best. And if you follow my channel here on YouTube, you'll see that I've painted like Casey Stoner, Nikki Hayden, Valentino Rossi, Mark Marquez and other people. The reason is I'm a really big fan of MotoGP. And now the new world champion for 2020 has been crowned, and his name is Joan Mir, and he's on a Suzuki. So this painting is gonna be of Joan Mir. Now the reason why you see it stapled like this is because a lot of times when customers wanna buy a painting, they want me to roll it and ship it up, because if you try to ship it as a flat canvas, the shipping gets very expensive. So a lot of professional artists do this, where they'll take a board and then stretch their canvases out and paint them in acrylic. And because acrylic is rubbery, you can roll it and it's not a problem. It's not gonna crack or do any damage. And then you can mail it to the person who purchased your painting. And when they're large like this, this is definitely the best way to do it. So I'm really excited about this one because I'm a fan of Joan Mir. I like the way he is, and he represents himself on the track, you know, soft spoken. And Suzuki hasn't won, I think, in about 20 years. So for them to win the championship is a really big deal. And the way Joan Mir actually carries himself, as far as, for instance, I'll give you guys an example. He was asked about the pressures of, before he had won the championship recently, he was asked like, how do you feel about the pressure of racing and trying to be MotoGP champion? And if you crash, you know, he loses. And he said, what kind of pressure? He said, that's not real pressure. Real pressure is putting food on the table and paying your rent because of COVID. And these guys are multimillionaires. They have multi-million dollar contracts, but he's very like down to earth and realizes that a lot of people in the world are struggling right now. So I think Joan Mir has a huge following because he's just really down to earth. So to paint a painting of him on a MotoGP bike, this is a big thing for me. I hope that you guys follow along and you enjoy it. I have it penciled out on canvas and it's super detailed. So I'll show you guys what that looks like, and you'll follow me paint this from start to finish. I'm gonna do this in acrylic paint, and hopefully you guys will enjoy this process. So come on and follow me while I do this painting. I typically start my paintings by blocking in areas of similar color. In this case, it's black. I then move on to the background, which is primarily gray in this particular painting. So there's no point in airbrushing it, so I'll just paint the entire area a solid gray and then airbrush over it. So now I'm moving to the left side of the painting and painting the inside of the rider, where it would show the background, as well as where the feet are and the rest of the left side of the painting. So when I do this, the entire background will be grayed out. Now moving to the upper portion of the left side, where the rider's helmet would be, and I'm establishing that gray background. Now I'm sort of just completing the rest of the areas that should be solid gray. I have extra material around the canvas so the person who owns it can stretch it around a canvas frame if they want, or they can mount it on a board. Here you can see I begin airbrushing the background. I'm putting in the streaks that are left as the riders go around this turn. They leave sort of like the tire marks on the ground. I go back to painting the blotches of black that I see. Just any area that's large and an area that's solid black, I normally hand paint. Here I begin laying the first layer of blue. I'm gonna go over this acrylic blue multiple times so that the area looks very flat and uniform. When you first do it, you're gonna see that it looks a little splotchy. That's kind of normal. The acrylic takes a few passes before you get a nice uniform color. At this point, I'm continuing my hand painting. I just want to build a very nice uniform blue, and it's going to take multiple passes.
but I know I'm gonna airbrush over this and make my tones and reflections and highlights and shadows. So it's really important that I get a nice uniform color first before I begin airbrushing anything on top. Here I begin the first airbrushing that I'm gonna do with detail. I'm not being super precise here, I'm just laying some colors down and then I'm gonna go in and tighten everything up. You can see that the blue looks a lot more uniform. Now I can airbrush over it. What I'm gonna do is make the illusion that the sun is shining through this paint, and you're gonna see like sort of like an aqua look, so that it looks like the pearl of the actual motorcycle is showing. So when I do the white highlight, you see sort of a pearl and then the striking blue. Although the fairing of the motorcycle is blue, you wouldn't see it that way in normal lighting. You're gonna see shades and patterns. So you have to observe the photo very closely and you'll see that there are areas that are darker where the fairing bends. This is what I'm replicating with the airbrush. I've hand painted the blocked in areas that are like color. So there's basically two blues in the arm, and now I'm gonna airbrush the shades and highlights that you see in the folds of the leather. The same effect that happens to the fairing also happens to leather. Although it's one blue, wherever the sun hits it, it's a little bit brighter and it sort of changes the hue. So you kind of have to be very observant of that and replicate it when you airbrush and also do your white highlights on top of it. Now I move on to the gloves, which are very detailed, and there's a lot of crinkles and sort of like bends in the leather. There's also different colors. I have to paint this very faithfully so that the effect looks photographic in the end. This is one of the most subtle effects, and it really sells the image as far as looking photographic. When you look at his abdomen, he actually has like yellow and blues in there that you can barely see. So the idea here is not to paint it black, but to paint what you can see and sort of knock it back with shadows. That'll really make it look photographic when you finish it. Here I flip the canvas upside down so I can do the top part of the arm. It just makes it easier for me to replicate it instead of me trying to reach over the top of the canvas. The helmet is super detailed. I got to hand paint and then airbrush over it. This is gonna take some working to make sure that everything is straight and that the tones look nice and solid, but you gotta make the helmet look as realistic as possible. All the race motorcycles have plastic windscreens that are very transparent. They reflect light, so I have to also copy that when I airbrush it. Here are some shots in progression just to show you the steps that are necessary to complete the painting and what we go through to get it done. Here's the finished painting. Hopefully you'll agree that it looks good and it looks very photographic. And I hope that this revealed the steps that I normally take to make a photographic looking canvas using an airbrush and acrylics. Thank you for watching, and until the next one.